Welcome back. In this video, I want to show you how I teach money to my kids. So we always start with the Kumon books. Now, I should stop here for a sec. The math curriculum we use does have money in there, but for me, I feel like money and time are concepts that need to be really practiced a lot to get the hang of it and become really good at it. So I supplement heavily in the money and time area. So I always start with the Kumon workbooks. This one is ages 5, 6, and 7. This one is just counting coins. But it's simple. So you're going to start by writing 1 to 100. Pennies, tracing those. Then you count by fives. And then the nickels. So you're learning one coin at a time, and then it starts to combine it as you go through the book. So you have to count the different coins together, different formats. So I like this book a lot. It's really great for beginners. And they have the second book in the series as well. This one's called My Book of Money, Dollars and Cents. It's for a little bit older kids, 6, 7, and 8. And this one starts off where the other book left off. Quick review about what each coin is. And I like these books show the front and back of coins, not just always the front. My daughter hasn't started this one yet. There's more combos. Then it adds dollars too. And you have to find the large amount of money in each row, things like that. So it's a really good book. Now, I also have other things I do besides the workbook. These are from themeasuremom.com. They were free when I got them. They might be a subscriber freebie, but it was several years ago. So definitely check it out. It's just a little money game. And so you start anywhere you want on the pigs, roll the dice, and then wherever you land on, you have to match that amount to the mountain here. And so each one gets harder, and eventually you have more, let's see, bigger coin amounts, multiple coins. So we do that, and then you can pick up a little coin playset from the dollar store to practice playing store or just practice counting out change. I got this either at the dollar store or the Target dollar spot years ago. They have the amount of actual coins, you have to match it up. I'm sure you could find this kind of thing multiple places. And this is just play money, but it's nice for younger siblings or older siblings that just want to practice playing with money in their games without losing the stuff you have for a curriculum. Just have the dollars printed on there. And a little wallet that comes with it. So that's nice to have just for younger siblings that want to be included. And this one at the dollar store, a little game where you have to match the little felt circles to the right amount. I have some money flashcards. And most of these are at different dollar stores or dollar spots at different places. So what is this? 1 cent penny. How much is this? 20 cents. So that's a fun little thing to do. And this brand is, what does it say? Just says first grade money flashcards. I think this is probably at the dollar store from the Clever Factory. These are also from the Measured Mom, and so I just laminated them and cut them out. They're supposed to be clip cards. You just put a little paper clip or whatever on the right answer, but I just let my kids touch it. And so they just have different ones, and you have to pick the right answer for each one. This I found on Pinterest. I don't know what blog made it, but it's cool because it has room for the different coins. So these are the quarters, dimes, nickels. Of course, they don't have one for pennies, so that'd be way too big. I also made this. It's just an empty can, and then I can see the numbers on there, kind of faded, but I just kind of measured each coin size and cut slits in it and then put a number there, and then it's full of real coins, and so my kids can just drop it in and match it to the numbers in the slits. So that's a fun hands-on activity. This year I added some math games. This is the allowance game. It's really fun and it's really easy for kids to play themselves. So here's the back of it. So it's kind of like Monopoly, but you don't buy a property per se. As you go around the board, you land on spaces that tell you to spend a certain amount or you get a certain amount. You pass the bank, you get a little bit of interest if you put money in there. You can buy a lemonade stand and charge people lemonade if they land on it. So that's really fun. This one's called Money Bags. I really like this game a lot. So here's the game board. When you go, you roll the dice, and then when you land on a spot, you spin the spinner. And whatever it lands on, you can't use that coin to count out the amount on the space. So if it's 25 cents, you might get a 5, so you can't use a 5 to count it out. Or a quarter, you have to count out a different way, which I really like that. You also have an any coin spot, so you can use any coins to do it. The money bags is 1 of every coin, which is 41 cents. And so if you land on a dollar, you get the money bag, and then you just replenish it with the bank. So every player can get it as many times as they land on stuff. There's no spaces where you lose money, which is nice for kids. There's no frustration with that. And then they have change it up spaces, and so you land on that one. You have to take some change and change it into something else, like some of your money and change it into something else. So like enough coins to make a dollar or enough coins to make 50 cents, something like that through the bank. So there's a lot of making change in this game and I really like it. And it doesn't take very long to play either. The last game we have this year is Clumsy Thief. This was probably for older kids, 8 and up. My 7-year-old did fine with it. My just turned 6-year-old, we played when she was 5, and she did not do very well with it. So we had to change the rules a little bit. So instead of making it add up to 100, we had to make it so she could just match the numbers. So basically you have these cards and everyone's working at the same time and switching stuff and sending people's piles. And so you just have to get your cards and make hundreds on each, like match whatever card you have to theirs to make $100. And then you get that pile of cards, but people can take it from you too. So it's really fun. It's fast paced, but you might need to modify it for younger children as well. So we do a lot of fun things with money, and then they're always getting practice. And we just do this, you know, first 3 or 4 years, and they start learning money just so they can really grasp it and understand how to make change and what each thing is worth and all that stuff.
Okay, so I just wanted to jump over to the computer really quick. So I want to show you this website that I found. It is fantastic. It's Finance in the Classroom. This is a Utah state curriculum. And I just want to show you a few of my favorite parts in this website. The Lessons and Activities tab here has financial education lessons already made for you from grades K through 12. Just click one. Each grade has financial activities in different academic areas. So for here, how people make things. You have the standards. I don't care about that. I don't follow Common Core at all. But it's nice to have the lesson plans here. They've got links to different videos and things that are part of the lesson. So it's pretty cool. They got all the different things like activity sheets, music connections. So there's lots of options here for you. If you don't want to do lesson plans, you can go here to resources and books and hover over it and then just click it. And then you can sort by age group and you can click up here with the topic or you can just scroll down and then they have books for each financial topic. So if you just wanted to do a living book type thing with money, you could totally do that. All the resources are here for you. Under the same tab, they also have these music songs that teach different topics. If you enjoy memory work with your kids, this might be something to look into. Online resources are just different websites about money, biz kids, all sorts of things. So this website is so well done, and there's so many resources you could do with your kids. And then student resources, they have online tools, different kinds of calculators, and their activities is really cool too, because it's all these online financial games that kids can play. They have some for teenagers too. So yeah, definitely check this out. This is a really cool website.
I just wanted to show you a few more resources. The first one we'll do is the Tuttle Twins. I'll come back to this one in a minute. The Tuttle Twins are a series of books. There's 12 in the series. And basically, the author has taken essays or economic books from different sources, read them, and then condensed them into a story. Not all of them are based on a book, but the majority of them are. So for example, The Law, you can go in the back and say, and it shows you what book it was based on. The stories are kind of a picture book type, but a little bit longer format than a normal picture book. And the story tells the concept of the book it's based on in a story that's easy for kids to understand. So they're nice. The illustrations are nice. Oops. So there's 12 of these in the series. And each book also has a teacher's guide and a student workbook as well. Oops. So I'm going to show you this right here, because it was on the top of of the ones I printed out. So here's The Road to Serfdom. This is based on the book The Road to Serfdom. You just changed the spelling from surf to surf. And again, you know, they're all the same format. But here is the teacher's guide and the student guide, or the parent guide, I mean. But why do these ideas matter? Helpful terms, misconceptions, how to refute them, page from history, why it matters today, who is the author, book summary, more books for the author, and then discussion questions and answers. The questions are pretty good. They're not fluffy. I think they really help kids and adults think about these things. And then this is the student book. And this has a lot of activities for younger kids and older kids. Coloring pages. This one you write what happened with each character. Writing practice. Word search to code the message. Writing assignment. Designing a banana to sell the stall in the story. Crossword. Maze. So lots of different activities. Bingo. Mad Libs. A writing assignment. Group discussion. This is a 300 to 400 word writing assignment. This is all about the book. And then they always have a recipe that goes along with the book. There's also a Tuttle Twins cartoon out. I have not seen it yet, but it would make a fun add-on to this if you decided to get this. And the last thing I want to show you is this Usborne set. So you have understanding money, understanding economics, and understanding business. So I'll just do a quick flip through of these. I'll do a full flip through of these and link them if you want to see them, see more of them. So it's just different things about businesses. I really like the setup of these books. I like the format of these a lot. And you could just read, you know, one page a day in morning time. Because you get quite the education, I think. It's quite the background. Yeah, so I'll do a full flip through of these and link them at some point. Understanding money. I think money is really important to teach kids and some adults, actually. It's not taught that well in public schools. Yes, I hope you enjoyed this video and got some great ideas for teaching money to your kids. If you have any fun money games or money ideas for teaching money, please leave it down below. And please like and subscribe. I'll see you next time.